Cool.
Amazing. That was fantastic. That was my favorite act of the day, actually. Really, really, really good. Wow. Energy from the audience, it was just fantastic. I'm so happy for you.
Yeah. Is it Durium kind of cheerful? I mean, I don't think we've ever had a dance act on this show that makes their own music as well. So you are incredible.
I'm actually going to question whether they are human. Welcome to our planet.
Yeah, you know what? This is the kind of act you want in a competition.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was really, really so good. And I could see how much time had gone into that. Everyone in this theater was rooting for you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Yeah, golden buzzer. That's a great trip back.
Yes.
So, so good.
You came for the golden buzzer, and you got it!
Yeah!
We can't wait to see you again in the live semi-final! Yeah!
Gosh, you brought a lot of people with you. Tell me your names, please.
So I'm Ravi, and this is my sister Mara, and this is my mum and dad.
Very, very nice to meet you. And how old are you?
So I'm 8 years old.
Okay. What made you decide to do this?
I've watched BGT all my life and always wanted to audition for it. And 2 years ago, I was diagnosed with a brain tumour, and I'm here to show no matter what life throws at you, you can still achieve your dreams.
Good for you. And how are you right now?
So, my brain tumour is stable, but I'm still living with the day-to-day effects.
So you've had a really tough time, haven't you?
Yeah.
Tell me about all these people behind you.
So, to support me, I brought a group of my friends and teachers from school, my family, some medical professionals who have helped me during my diagnosis, some other amazing children from the brain tumour community.
Oh, God. Mum and Dad are joining in.
And what are you going to be doing for us today?
So today we're doing a choir performance of A Million Dreams.
Oh, my God.
OK. Take your time. Whenever you're ready, we're ready.
That we desire.
You are very talented, very brave, very special person. I'm so happy that you've had this moment, because you deserve it, all of you, by the way. That's what I call magic. And that's why we have the golden buzzer for people like you. You so deserve it. Make it nice and make it
clear. Well, you know, the golden buzzer is such a personal thing, and I always say I can only press it when it feels right, and you're such a remarkable young man.
You're a hero.
You really are. The moment you started talking, you just had me.
Yeah.
And, I just loved it. Oh, so God. Well done to all of you.
Thank you for doing that. Yeah.
We'll see you in the live semi-finals.
Darling.
Hello, everyone. My name's Sydney Christmas.
Is it?
Sydney Christmas.
That's an unbelievable name. I love that.
It's terrible, isn't it?
It's not.
My middle name's worse.
What is it?
Mary.
No. Sydney Mary Christmas.
Did your mum seriously name you that?
No, I'm joking. Yeah. I ain't really.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. That is genius. Sydney, where are you from?
Raised in Kent, just moved to London.
Are you a student? Do you work? What do you do?
I'm currently working front of house at a gym.
Oh, brilliant.
Ooh, yes.
Fantastic, but that's not what you want to do.
No, absolutely not.
No. What do you want to do, Sydney?
I'm trying to be in the West End. I just want to sing.
Oh, bless her.
What are you going to sing for us today?
The first song that I ever sung, actually. I haven't sung it in 24 years.
How old are you? You look 24.
28.
20 great.
Good answer.
Thank you.
There you go.
So what song did you sing it for?
Tomorrow.
From Annie?
From Annie, yeah.
Oh. Simon, that is Simon's worst song.
Hopefully I'll sing it better. Then when I was four as well.
So do we.
I can't wait.
Thank you.
Sid.
Come on, Sydney.
Come on, Sydney.
Let's have it.
The sun will come out tomorrow, bet you bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sun. I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely. I just stick out my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may. The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about
want more. Tease them, bring them in, make them believe, hit them with this huge note. It's just art. It's all art. Art.
You are full of character, personality. You've got it all going on. Say no more, girl. Smashed it. Let's have it.
Let's have it.
Come on, Sydney.
I think for me, what struck me so much about you is just like how naturally funny, how warm, how brilliant your presence was the minute you walked on the stage, but how you were like entertaining everyone, but then you brought us the most heartfelt, beautiful version of that song. And that was the best version I have ever heard in my life. So I'm gonna do this.
We just heard in the room, it was, you know, it's rare.
Thank you so much. Thanks for screaming for me.
Everyone's aware, you know, it's tough to get that break, you know, for something which you really love. You so deserve what you just got.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Your control was amazing. And I used to hate that song, and now I absolutely love it. Good for you. That was brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
See you in the live show.
What just happened there?
She really deserved that, though, Charles.
So good, yeah. She proper gave me chills all over my body. I was like, oh, my God.
Everybody was just in the palm of your hand.
I have never experienced anything like
really?
That. Ever. I really felt hurt. That was something.
Oh, good.
I'll never forget that.
I look at her and I go, my daughter's going to love her, my nan's going to love her, and my mum's going to love her. Yeah. That's how I always judge it, like the three different generations. Yeah.
Yes.
Great name.
We are double that team.
Double Dutch, skip in.
Where are you guys from?
We came from Japan for 20 hours to do this performance.
Yay! Have you come here to win?
Yes, of course.
Yes. Okay, I'm not going to ask any more questions. Good luck.
Oh, thank you.
Warming up is very good. You have to get ready. Yeah. Stretch.
Yeah.
Come on, limber up.
Why are you limbering up?
Just in case it's... I have to get involved.
I'm sitting here thinking, I genuinely don't know what to say. When it's brilliant like this, it's just, words aren't really necessary. Sorry, my son is literally going crazy right now.
Is there anyone who thinks they deserve a golden buzzer? Son, Amanda's daughter, egged on by the audience. We are going to see you in the finals. Congratulations. I'm gonna give this one to all of you. Thank you.
That's never happened before. Congratulations. You came to BGT and got a golden buzzer.
And where are you boys from?
We're from all over the UK. I'm from Kent, Maidstone.
Yeah.
I'm from Cheshire near Manchester.
I'm from Glasgow.
They got the country covered, haven't they?
Yeah. And because you're from all over the place, how on earth do you get to rehearse?
So we meet up in either London, Birmingham or Manchester.
Right.
And so we've had three rehearsals so far
for this performance.
Only three?
Only three?
Yep.
Are you feeling nervous?
Yeah.
All our friends and family are in the audience today and we can't wait to show them how hard we've worked. And I hope they're so proud of us.
So, we got this.
If you went on to win Britain's Got Talent, what would you spend the money on?
So, we would spend it on a new facility,
a permanent facility for Phoenix to meet up more often and so that we can have somewhere to go to. And the rest would probably go towards our families and college funds.
Amazing. Brilliant. Well, you're off the hook. I'm not going to ask you any more questions. I'm just going to say, make the next 3 or 4 minutes count. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good
luck.
There's a feeling, there's a fire, there's a whisper preaching to the choir. Take the leaders and the liars, throw your fears on the funeral pyre. Keep on breathing, don't go under. Mother, sister, father, brother, step into the light and start a tiny fire. Stop being so goddamn cautious. Of a tiny riot.
Understand how hard it is to succeed as a dancer. The work that goes into it and the passion, and literally you do it for nothing, you do it for love. And I felt that.
I get it. You're very emotional. I understand.
Congratulations, boys. I could see the emotional connection that Bruno felt, and I knew that he could see himself in you.
Amanda?
I loved it. I loved the choreography. I really loved the power and the energy that you all have. And I love the fact that there's age difference between you all, because I can see there's mentoring and care and friendship in this group. So for me, that meant everything.
Bruno.
I literally can't speak. What really touches people is when you perform from your heart, is the truth of your performance. That's really what remains in people's mind. And you touch me, and I think you touched everybody here.
What I really liked about all of you is that you only had a little bit of time to do this. Three rehearsals is nothing. And I think Bruno's given you this great opportunity now that when you come back to the finals, you come back even better than what we saw today. Enjoy this moment. I know this means a lot. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm so excited.
Okay, what is the name of the group?
We are Team Ssaulabi from South Korea.
Ah. And why are you here on the show?
We are here to do something I've never seen before on BGT.
Do you think you can win?
Our act fit for loyal family.
Oh, that's amazing. That's what the show is all about. Okay, well, we have no idea what you're going to do. We love surprises and the best of luck.
Thank you.
Let's go, Ssaulabi. Can't wait for this.
Pre-match huddle.
We do that before every show ourselves.
Don't knock me head off. Remember, don't knock me head off.
Don't kick us in the face.
Don't kick us in the face.
Whoa!
you're alive!
Excellent!
The power, the beauty, the artistry, it blows everything else I've seen out of the water. Insane, incredible.
My goodness, I need more of that. I can't even imagine how much discipline, hard work and dedication that it's taken for you to achieve what you just did there today. It was exciting. You've got us screaming. Genuinely, that might be one of the best things I've ever seen on this show.
My mind was blown. It was like a Quentin Tarantino movie. I couldn't get over it.
I totally agree with everything everybody said. I think the fact that you've come here to represent your country and show us what you've done, which must have taken years to achieve this. It was more than a 10, it was an 11.
An 11? He never gives 11.
Never.
Ever.
That performance will inspire other people because it was just hard work and brilliance. Congratulations. Ooh.
Well done! Ah. Well done!
Congratulations! Well done!
Well done!
I am exhausted!
That's up there. That is up there.
Oh, I like that.
Thank you! Thank you!
And what are your names, please?
My name is Vlada, I'm 25.
Hello.
And I'm Zhenya, I'm 27.
Okay, and tell us about you.
We are married couple from Ukraine.
Okay, so I can see, I think, the type of act this is. Who inspired you?
This stage actually inspired us. We watched Billy and Emily perform here.
I remember Billy and Emily.
They were great.
Really good.
This performance made such a big impact on us, so we decided to start our roller skating journey.
And let me ask you a question. Who is better, you or Billy and Emily?
This is an unfair question.
No one's going to hear about this.
I think we both have our own things that makes us special.
Is this act something that could win, go global, change your lives?
Absolutely. So much.
It would means that our talent is really worth showing to royal family and to everybody all over the world.
Yeah.
I understand. All right, no more questions. Let's do it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
One of the hardest things you can do.
They kissed. They just kissed. Good little kiss.
impressive.
The combination of roller skating aerialism, it was so spectacular, so thrilling. Perfection.
That is how you do it. Honestly, we knocked it out of the park. That was sensational, and you look incredible together, both of you, stunning.
This show is always about raising the levels every single year, and I'm going to say it, you did, and it was insane.
It was amazing.
Fantastic. Seriously, that's what this is all about. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Go and celebrate.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
This is yes. This is what I call a yes.
Well done.
I mean, how could you not? It was just sensational. Absolutely sensational.
In more ways than one, and then golden buzzer.
What's your name?
Taryn.
Taryn, where are you from?
Egham in Surrey.
I used to live there. Englefield Green.
Englefield Green is where I live. Yes.
OMG. Taryn, why have you decided to come on Britain's Got Talent?
I love to make people smile, and I think my voice is all right. So.
And Taryn, did you bring anyone with you?
Yeah, I did. I brought one of my students, Lexi Ray. She's over there. And she's with her mum. So I work with special needs children to use music as a way.
If you won Britain's Got Talent, how would that change your life?
It would mean everything.
Well, darling, listen, you've got 2 minutes. Take a deep breath. Good luck.
Thank you.
Hello.
OK.
She's good, isn't she?
is talent. That is talent.
The old saying, you could sing the phone book. I feel like you've got that classic voice. But above and beyond that, you, my darling, you are special.
Honestly, from the minute you stepped foot, just chatting to you, you are so down to earth, so sweet, so humble. And then you knocked it out of the park. But I can see how much that moment meant to you. You're physically shaking now, and I'm thrilled. Absolutely thrilled you've got this chance.
Thank you so much!
Because I know I'm not bragging here, but I had the honour to meet Carole King. She stayed at my house. And when you started this song, I said, oh, God, how is she going to do this? You made me forget about her version. You made it so much your own, with so much feeling, and the colour of your voice is unique. And you're a very, very, very special person, my darling.
Thank you so much.
You sold us a complete dummy, didn't you? I mean, yeah, I'm all right. Yeah, I might do okay.
I could see you were nervous.
And I was thinking, this probably isn't going to be very good. and then you started singing. And this is how people should sing. This is proper, proper singing. Has someone ever told you that you couldn't do this?
Yes.
Okay.
I could see you were nervous, and I was thinking, yeah, I bet you somebody at some point has said to you, you haven't got a great voice or nothing's gonna ever happen. And boy, did you prove that person wrong. And that's what that golden buzzer is all about. Yeah. And Bruno, brilliant.
Yes.
And you are a little star.
Thank you so much. Get the gold!
Superb, absolutely superb.
That was great.
You're the best!
How did it feel?
I don't even know what to say. I think I've wet myself.
Thank you!
What's your name?
My name is Nabe.
Fantastic. And where have you come from today?
Oh, I'm from Japan.
Amazing.
Yeah. 25 hours flight.
Oh my gosh. Well, thank you for making the effort. We're grateful, aren't we?
Yes.
And tell me, why are you here?
I want to make people smile all over the world. Thank you.
Are you here to win?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
good luck.
Thank you, thank you, thank you!
I'm intrigued as to what he's going to do.
He's a dentist. He wants to make people smile all over the world.
OK. It's impression showtime! Let music come on! Come on, come on, come on, come on! Woo-hoo! Come on, come on, come on!
Thank you!
I love it!
Oh,
thank you very much!
Woo! Shaun the Sheep had so much in common. It's amazing. Right, put this.
Wow.
Put the, whoa, tuck whoa, it okay, up okay. There.
Wow, thank you.
Tuck it there.
Go to the here.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much. Amazing.
Oh, God, I love him so much. You know when you want to laugh so much, I feel like I can't get enough out of me.
Yeah.
Normally, when I press my golden buzzer, I'm then in floods of tears and I do a big speech.
However,
this is so different. It's just made me howl. Absolutely laugh my head off. I've never seen anything like it. You were so funny.
One of the funniest people we've ever had, and the only person I've ever known who does impersonations with their hair. I mean, this is genius. Absolutely genius.
What was coming next? Not really, not a clue. And every time you surprise me, you're very, very funny.
Shaun the Sheep.
Shaun the Sheep. Love you. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
You look very surprised.
I'm surprised.
I'm surprised.
Did it?
Golden buzzer.
Golden buzzer.
Wow.
Congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much.
I know we only get one, but I got that feeling where I absolutely had to press the golden buzzer.
What are the three things that you love about yourself?
Humility, yes, charm,
humble.
Good looks, humility, generous, I like people, I wear great clothes, I'm funny, I'm great fun to have dinner with and breakfast and lunch, great to go on holiday with, I like guys, I like girls, I like animals.
I know you do!
Let's replay that clip again. Ladies and gentlemen, I like girls, I like guys.
Thank you.
You finally said it. And you like animals as well. We're not going there.
David, who do you think has got a tattoo of you on them?
Obviously David.
You're going to say David, right? Would the judge who has the tattoo please reveal themselves? Oh, David, it is. This is the thing. Let's see the tattoo. 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 Tattoo.
Tattoo. You know what? I'm not paid enough money to deal with that. Seriously?
I tell you something.
I actually feel sick.
But what?
That's weird. Why are you laughing?
Do you want to try it again?
I didn't like it.
I did it for you.
What is the one thing about Simon that you don't know that you would like to know?
Oh, good question. Oh, no. You know everything, don't
David.
You? Good question.
Don't go there.
Okay.
I like your baby.
You've
got a contract for next year. You can have a 2-year extension.
I would like. We are after the watershed, are we?
Yes.
No, we're not. No, we're not.
Oh,
no, we're not. We're not after the watershed.
I would like to see
David.
Inside his house.
Oh,
he's never invited. These two girls have been to his house.
Right.
I haven't.
Why has David never been to your house?
He's scared.
I don't really like him that much.
And while I'm at his house, I'd like to see his
Oh,
but I do think his comments were out of order today.
Yes, yeah.
Just for me, you could throw water over him again.
I'm sorry?
Do you think just for me, you could throw water over him again?
Oh, no! Oh, no! Thank you, Noah.
Thank you.
Noah.
Thank you very much. Thanks for that question.
Emily. Hello, Emily.
Hi, Stephen.
Hi, Emily. I'm sure you just saw what happened. What's your question? Who's it for?
So, I also love David, but I did actually think his comments to Alicia were pretty out of order. My question is also for Alicia. Can you also throw water over David for me, too?
What has this turned into?
Hi, Simon.
How are you?
You are my family's favourite judge, believe it or not.
I do believe it.
But if you had to choose between your America's Got Talent judging panel or your Britain's Got Talent judging panel, which one is your favourite and why?
Oh.
Well, to be fair, they are more intelligent in America.
Ooh, in America?
In America, yeah.
No, they are. I don't mean that disrespectfully.
Don't mean that disrespectfully?
No, they are more intelligent.
What, Heidi Klum? She's thick as pig shit.
Now he can't be sacked. He'll just say anything he wants.
Exactly. See, as I said, he'll be out of control now.
Taking that to a side, look, it's difficult. I like them both. I like these guys because they're sort of stupid.
Hi there. So my question is for David.
Right.
So, David, we've seen a lot of good magic acts on the show so far. But don't you agree with me that the real magic on the show has to be Simon?
That's a great question.
What's his name?
Karen.
Karen, that's a great question.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's magical how a man of 85 still looks like that. he's had some assistance of some kind, isn't he? My goodness. Yeah, it is magic. It is fun. The weird thing is, although I know you pretty well, I actually do get starstruck every time I see you. I go, oh my God, it's Simon Cowell! Every time I see you. It's the weirdest thing. That's weird.
Do you get starstruck with him?
No.
There you go. Then he just lose the will. Well,
that was one of the best moments ever.
We ate it tonight.
What?
I feel bad for you guys who actually had to film that at the front.
In the game.
Out of your fellow judges, which would you snog, marry, or avoid?
Oh!
And you have to answer.
Answer,
I'll die in a plane crash.
Oh, well, that's good.
Don't even joke about that.
Well, I will.
Alicia, right, that's snog. Who are you going to snog?
Oh, I can't.
Exactly. Yes, you have to.
I'm
Alicia.
Oh, I'd snog Amanda.
Snog Amanda. Oh. Let's see it.
We did already.
A little peck on the lips. Love you. Right.
marry?
Who would you marry?
I'd marry Simon for the money.
That's my girl. Oh, by process of elimination.
And I'd avoid David because he's married.
Oh,
yes,
I'm married to a supermodel.
Exactly. Do you know what he is? And it's interesting, and it is often people who are really, really, really famous. He is incredibly generous with his time with people, more than any other star I've ever seen.
Can we have an R for that? Come on. What a lovely way to finish our nice judge.
But for some reason, that's nice of you, David, but I feel uncomfortable now.
You know,
because you're not used to me paying you a compliment.
No, I know, and it just doesn't sit
right. Just take it for what it is.
No, I can't. It just doesn't feel comfortable.
Well, would you feel more comfortable if he gave you a hug?
Yeah. Come give me a hug.
Give him a hug. Come on. Hug it out.
Come give me a hug.
Hug it out. That's it.
Come and give me a hug. Come on. No, I didn't say sit down.
Give him a lovely hug.
I didn't say sit down.
Give him a lovely hug. That's it. Isn't that nice?
The country's on the hunt for the next Prime Minister. Out of all the judges, who would make the best Prime Minister and why?
Who would make the best Prime Minister?
Out of the three of them.
If it was a dictatorship, Simon Cowell. I think Alicia would be a wonderful Prime Minister. I think she would. I think she's the natural. No offence to you, Amanda, but she's the naturally the nicest person on the panel. I think she is. There's nothing. You've got an edge.
How do you feel about that, Amanda?
Alicia?
Because I say bad things.
Because you said the F word at 8 o'clock at ITV.
I'm too naughty to be Prime Minister. Yeah. We'll be right back.